We told you earlier that we'll be getting you a special conversation with Shivlal Yadav. My colleague Shivani Gupta now joins us. Shivani, over to you.
Thanks a lot, Pierre. He's the man of the moment. Shivlal Yadav, all set to take charge of the BCCI as the interim president today. Following the Supreme Court's order, Yadav is travelling to Mumbai later to take charge of all non-IPL affairs of the BCCI. Remember, last month, the Apex Court had asked N. Srinivasan to step aside while the Mudgal panel reporters heard and argued. And the SC had appointed Vice President Shivlal Yadav to take care of all BCCI matters. Yadav will have his task cut out with several issues that will be key while this case is heard. First and foremost, how much involvement displaced President N. Srinivasan will have in ICC matters? A reading of the order suggests representing the BCCI at the ICC would be a function of the president and therefore should fall to Yadav. But could the BCCI appoint Srinivasan to represent instead of him? To answer that and some more questions, Shivlal Yadav joins us live and exclusive for a first conversation since becoming the interim president of the BCCI. Mr. Yadav, thanks a lot for joining us. You're going to be traveling to Hyderabad very shortly. Also joining us is our consulting editor, Boria Majumdar from Kolkata. Mr. Yadav, if I can come to you first, as you approach your job today, travel to Mumbai a little later, what are your thoughts about the kind of responsibility that has been entrusted in you?
Well, the responsibility is very high because since I am there only for 5 months, the situation is not so good as one would expect. But since I have been given the responsibility, I have to accept the challenge and look forward to see that Indian cricket doesn't get further beating.
Right, Indian cricket doesn't get further beating. That's a very important responsibility, Mr. Yadav. What is it that you would first approach to do in your job as the BCCI interim president? What is priority for you right now?
Well, basically to see get the fans back, to get the confidence of the cricket fans back, and make sure that we develop our infrastructure like NCA back on coaching panel, because last few years we have not been coaching at Bangalore. So under 16, under 19, I would like to concentrate more on cricketing matters which have been lacking in the past couple of years.
All right, you're saying you want to concentrate on cricketing matters, but something tells me, sir, you'll be very busy looking at other matters first, at least till this case is being heard. Before I toss to my colleague Boria Majumdar, who has a few questions to you, many people are saying you looked at someone close to N. Srinivasan and therefore perhaps not the best man for this job given the circumstances right now. What would you have to say?
Well, in BCCI, everybody is a friend of mine. I've been there for the last 6-7 years as vice president. And you develop good rapport with each individual. So you can't really say that I'm a Srinivasan's man or I'm XYZ's man. I will take my decisions as and when cricketing nature is required.
All right, you're saying you're your own man and you'll take your own decisions. Boria, questions for Shivlal Yadav?
Absolutely.
Yes, please, Shivani. Thank you very much. Shivlal Bhai, good to hear you saying you will take decisions by your own. Three questions to start with and then a couple of follow-ups. One, the question that the whole world is asking you, who represents India in the ICC? Is it the interim president Shivlal Yadav or is it the president in exile, N. Srinivasan? What will happen when India is represented in the ICC?
Well, Boria, this matter is to be decided by the working committee. I alone can't take that decision because it concerns BCCI as whole. So I will put it to the working committee and the working committee will decide who should represent in the ICC.
So what you are telling us is, in effect, it is not a fait accompli that Srinivasan will go. It is to be decided by the working committee. Am I right in understanding what you are saying?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Mr. Yadav, you've just told my colleague Shivani that you want to restore the fans' faith. Would you agree that what has happened over the last few months, Indian cricket's image has taken a serious tarnishing? would you agree that if, you know, serious corrective measures are in order? Would you agree with that assessment?
Yeah, absolutely, I agree with that, and that is where we have to put our heads together and see that the BCCI's image is restored and the fans' confidence is back.
Mr. Yadav, yesterday a startling announcement, you have withdrawn yourself from the Hyderabad Cricket Association polls. Now, hardly few people in India do that they withdraw themselves from a poll when you are actually in power. What prompted you to withdraw yourself from HCA polls, and can you elaborate on what your future plans are?
Well, Borya, my personal perception is that once you reach the top, you have to make room, be there, whatever contribution you can do, you give it, and then thereafter make room for others, so that there will be newer ideas, newer challenges they will be facing. So it is best that you are, when you are at the top, you should do your job and make room so that the next generation can take over.
Mr. Yadav, two more questions before I hand it over to Shivani again. One, you say the image has taken a beating, correctives are in order. Would you agree that a probe, thorough probe, is required to get into the bottom of this IPL mess? I know you are not in charge of IPL, but the BCCI, would it want to undertake a thorough investigation to get to the root of this problem?
Well, Borya, the matter is sub judice, so I would rather not comment on that. What sort of probe is required? Because since the matter is with the Supreme Court, I think the courts will decide what sort of action to be taken next.
Final question from my side. You are taking charge today. Many congratulations on that. Can you outline your first steps?
Thank you.
Once you reach Bombay later today, what will be your first steps?
Well, first of all, my first step would be is to find out from the Honorary Treasurer to see that, because last working committee meeting I had suggested to then President Mr. Srinivasan that the other Ranji Trophy cricketers who were left out, below 75 matches were left out. I had suggested to him that we should take care of them as well. Like we gave those who have played 75 matches and above, we gave them 25 lakhs of rupees. So I was suggesting to him then at least 15 lakh of rupees in different categories we can make and make some sort of a payment to them, so that their future is also secured, because they also did not get much while they were playing. So that is one. Number two is that I want to relook at the NCA, that the coaching pattern which we, when I was the director, we used to have regular coaching for under 16 and under 19, and they used to play a tournament called Colonel Hemu Adhikari tournament. So I would like to see that sort of format is back, so that the younger generation gets the advantage of getting coached at NCA. And a few other things like improving the domestic wickets. What I've seen when I went as manager a couple of seasons ago, I've seen that our batsmen were lacking in the in tackling the bounce and pace and the seeming conditions. So I would request all the BCCI members to see that the wickets in their respective grounds are redone and relooked at, so that we get more bouncier tracks. Our younger cricketers can get used to that.
All right, Mr. Yadav.
Shivani, over to you.
Yeah, thank you. Mr. Yadav, the other burning issue right now is the conflict of interest. Already, several employees of the ICL have been booted out of the BCCI functioning. Would you also take a very stern view of this conflict of interest and continue to kind of press forward the Supreme Court's wishes and orders that no ICL employee then has any capacity in the BCCI?
Well, who is Shivlal Yadav to defy that? Once the Supreme Court has given an order, we have to follow it in totality. So whatever they have given in the order, we have to obey it, and we will obey it.
Mr. Yadav, but don't you think that this conflict of interest has really hurt the BCCI's image, and now perhaps it will be up to you and Sunil Gavaskar, who's heading IPL matters, to kind of, you know, restore the fans' faith, as you were saying, in this regard too, that, you know, ICL employees or even N. Srinivasan will still not control the functionings of the body?
Well, as I said before, the matter is sub judice, and we will wait since the Supreme Court has already allocated IPL to Mr. Gavaskar, and I will have to look after the BCCI affairs. I think that is very, very clear that different roles are being set up for both. So I think if we stick to that and look forward to improving the image of the BCCI, that should do.
All right. Shivlal Yadav there saying that he's going to be his own man. He shouldn't only be looked as such and such's man or Srinivasan's man, and he's going to take steps first and foremost to restore fans' faith in the BCCI and in cricket. Borya Majumdar and Shivlal Yadav, the interim president of the BCCI, thanks a lot for joining us. Mr. Yadav, we wish you all the best, and we hope that you succeed in your endeavours to clean our cricket.